Hi YouTube, it's Gwen. I'm back. Long time no see here. All that good stuff. I'm coming on very quickly because I'm in the actual process right now of preparing to go out of town. And so, but each time I wash my hair lately, it's been very tangled. Harder to tangle. I have areas that's harder to tangle. And I know it's because I need a trim. So this is a quick little method that I thought up in my head that I would try out to trim my ends, because usually what I do is go row by row and make mini twists or smaller twists to cut my hair. I have become so lazy with my hair, and I'm basically just washing it, conditioning it, and I've started using activator. That's a separate video that I'm about to that I'll get into. Let me stretch it out some so I can twist it. But yeah, if you notice your hair is really tangly, it's probably time to trim it. It's probably time for a trim. And rather than hop in the shower, which I'm about to do, and go through that whole process of all those tangly danglies, I said, I'm gonna trim it real quick and see how that improves my detangling, because I only detangle in the shower. That's the only time, with a head full of conditioner and my modified knockoff dimming brush. That's the only time I detangle my hair. Other than that, I'm usually picking my hair out with a pick. I don't go through and just full on detangle. Right now I'm kind of doing some finger detangling and stretching so that I can get it straight as possible to get it into a twist. And so I think that will definitely help the process, having my hair straighter. Because I think a lot of times when you go natural, you don't want to cut your hair because you want it to grow. I want it to grow. But if it's so tangly, which I had locks and I didn't cut my hair just most even, and that is part of my problem, because I have areas that don't tangle. If I would have taken more time cutting it when I took my locks down, I wouldn't be having this issue right now. But I was anticipating on going into a taper fade, which didn't happen. I got lazy and just start wearing natural styles, froze, things like that. So yeah, that's what happened with that. But so this method I'm hoping works and decreases the tanglies that I'm experiencing. And yeah, so that's pretty much what I do right there. And you can even see right there how the unevenness, that stringy part on the end, that definitely has to go. I'm trying to keep it pretty even because my hair is already pretty uneven. So what I think I'm going to do is go to the fattest part there and cut. And go to the fattest part here. Go to the fattest part here. This is kind of fuzzy, actually. It's still kind of fuzzy. And cut it there. That looks about even. And that's the thing about cutting curly hair. Curly hair is extremely forgiving. It's not like straight hair. You don't have to be exactly perfect. And it's still going to look good. So, like I said, I try to go to the fattest part and cut. And that's what I'm doing. See, all of this, even though it's long, it's so wispy. I don't know if you can see it. It's long, but look how wispy it is. So I'm just going to the fattest part of the twist. Fattest part of the twist. And cut. That one's a little shorter than the other side, but I think this side was a little more damaged. So it's okay. It's hair. It'll grow back. And oh, the other thing I've been using, like I said, is activator. And I'm going to have a video up soon. I've been working so much, and I have been really just trying to get back on track with my diet, because I am allergic to wheat, and everything that's good has wheat in it. So it's been really a struggle. When I don't eat things with wheat, my face clears up. I don't get the breakouts that I get when I'm eating wheat. So that, not only is it about hair, it's about health as well. So yeah, I am working on a couple of different things. But yeah, the activator has really, and I mean really, changed my hair's life. And so it's something I've been kind of focusing on. And then for the back, I just really got super lazy, and it is really just one plait, and I'm just kind of going on feel of where to cut it at in the back. So yeah, so that is my quick way to trim my hair. Like I said, this is a cheat method for trimming my hair, because usually what I do is go through in each individual just mini twist. And I'm sure I'll be trimming a little more as I go take my hair down and go through. But that's the quickest way to get off that, the dead hair. That's the quickest way. This one might could even be cut a little more. But yeah, I won't do too much, because you can always cut a little more. Once it's gone, that's the issue. So cut sparingly. But yeah. So now I've done my cuts, and I'm gonna hop in the shower. But I did want to get on and do a quick little update of what's going on with me. I have forgot you guys. I just been working and trying to figure life out. I think that's all what we all doing, going through life every day. This, oh, let me untwist it, because it's tangled and caught on a tangle. So yeah, that's what I've been doing. And like I said, I'm sure I will be doing some more trimming. Yeah, because right now I can see this right here needs to be trimmed. Clearly it needs trimming, because the end is very wispy and spidery. So I'm gonna just trim it. But yeah, so that's what I'm doing. And I've done this before, but it's been a while, because like I said, I've been just trying to focus on growth. But sometimes part of growth is cutting. So you got to remember that too. If it's really super tangly, you probably need to trim it. So don't be afraid to trim your natural hair, because the key to growing natural hair is moisture. So if you keep your hair moist, it's going to grow back. And that's another thing. I frequently, like every 3 days, wash my hair, especially with using this activator, because activator really coats your hair, so it's good to wash it out. But that's another video. I just want to show you my quick method to a quick cut, just to get some of the tangles out. All right, you guys, see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Oh yeah, I'm still using the VO5 to wash my hair. Today, I usually use my Garnier Fructis Clean and Pure. In the green bottle, but I'm gonna try this today just because it's cheaper, and if it works, I'll start using it. So I'll give you a review on that as well. I think I stopped using it because it didn't detangle as well. It didn't have as much slip. I think that's why I stopped using it, but I always kind of revisit products. If it's a change in price or a change in quality, I start reviewing stuff again. So, all right, I'm rambling. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, tell everybody you know to watch my channel. See you in the next video. Bye.